Anyone who understands what is the meaning of passive study and active study, and those people who already know, who are already the part of mains marathon, please don't reply, because I know that you are already applying this principle in your studies. I would like to know from new people, what is the difference between passive study and active study? And please interact with me. I always believe in interaction. This is not one-way class. This is an informal interaction kind of thing. My purpose is to maximize your productivity. And those people who are using the camera, you can stop your camera right now so that there is no distraction. Active, I guess, is when you're mindful of what you are studying. Okay. Passive is, I guess, when we just study for the sake of completing the targets, not proper time management. Okay. So who would like to tell me the meaning of active study? And those people who are part of our program, please don't tell. ठीक है, जो mains marathon वाले हैं आप मत बताइएगा. I want to know from the new people. Okay, so I want to know from at least one person, how do you do the study? For example, I give you the target of fundamental rights chapter. Okay, so I would like to know from at least one person. You can unmute yourself and you can speak out to me. I mean, just share with me. I'm just like your elder brother, and just tell me, how do you do the study? So who would like to volunteer? Please participate, and don't worry about right, wrong. Don't worry about perfect, whether my strategy is perfect or not. No, we are not going into right or wrong here. We are just looking into, what is the best way? Because ultimately all of us are here to qualify the exam, not to become the scholar of Lakshmikant polity. It will not give you any job. You will not get any reward if you are mastering the Lakshmikant book. So I need at least one volunteer who can come and who can share, how do you study? Who would like to share? By heart the point which is most confusing. Okay, please come forward. Yeah, if you are not coming forward, then how will I proceed? I don't want to make this teaching session, because then it will not be effective. Yes, Karishma.
Hi, sir.
Yes, Karishma.
So I would just open the book. I would read the chapter, scribble the points or something I teach around, and scribble it on the paper. I would have already have my notes. But anyways, I will still take the book, read it, scribble it on the paper. And that's how I study, sir.
Okay. So what do you do? For example, we give you the target of fundamental rights.
Yes, sir.
You will open the book of
I would like make a table and remember the exceptions, because that's what I think was a little confusing. So okay. I would just scribble on the exceptions again and again. So every time I read, I would just scribble it.
Okay. Very good. Thank you for sharing. Okay. So that is how we have been doing. I offer you one more methodology where what you do, because I'm assuming that you have already gone through this Lakshmikant at least once before we are doing the revision now. As far as I know, most of you have already gone through the Lakshmikant at least once. So one thing is, like, I open the book of Lakshmikant and I just, start reading the book. That is the passive study. In the active study, what you are supposed to do, for example, you open the chapter of fundamental rights. So what you will be doing, you pick one A4 size paper, and on that A4 size paper, take it in the landscape format and write fundamental rights. Suppose this is the paper. In the center, you are writing fundamental rights. Now you will start thinking whatever you know already about the fundamental right. Okay. So what you will do, for example, okay, what is the meaning of fundamental right? Some important features, are they justiciable? What are the rights of individual? What are the rights of state? Then, which all articles are there? So what you're doing, you're just writing, okay, this is, we can this is justiciable, and they are it starts from article number this and it ends at article number this. Okay, we have these many number of fundamental right, and these are the groups. Okay, and article number 14 says this exception is this. Article number 15 says this. So what you are doing, you did not open the book. Before opening the book, you are just recalling whatever you already know. Okay, and you are just, you know, writing those points in a random manner in the paper. So that recalling should not be done without paper. If you do that recalling without paper, then it will, you know, after some time you will get lost. You know, you will be again you'll confused, and you will again come back to the book and start studying in the passive manner. No. You are supposed to open the fresh page and do this exercise over there. So whatever you know, all the possible dimension. Okay, for example, what are the fundamental rights in case of emergency, and what are the fundamental rights available to the foreigners? Just, you know, whatever dimension you are able to recall, try to stress your mind. And let me tell you, your mind is very, very powerful. Very, very powerful. Give it a chance. It will produce the result. Now, I want to know, if you do this exercise, what are the benefits that you can see? Who will tell me? Whatever comes to your mind, I would like to know, what benefit do you expect from this exercise? Please reply in the chat box or unmute yourself. Okay, very good. We will know what we don't know. Okay, very good. What else? Everyone, please give the answer. You know, it's not about right or wrong answer. It's about you participating. Remember the point, okay? What else? So I'm just writing your point. Memory power increase. Okay, very good. When you are using your mind in a proper manner, then definitely it will show up its power. And don't you think you will save the time doing this work? Yeah, retention will be higher. That will be in our brain for long term. Very good. Absolutely. And don't you think, you will save your time? And don't you think you will be more excited doing this exercise rather than opening the book and studying this Lakshmikanth? Lakshmikanth is so boring, yaar. And it's very, very boring. Very, very boring. You know, kisi ka man nahi karta Baba Lakshmikanth khol ke padhne ka. Pagal ho gaye hain pad ke Lakshmikanth ko. Okay? So, aapko nahi lagta ki which will be something new, which never tried, and like we are testing ourselves. You know? And one more thing. When we are not able to recall something, you know, it will create a vacuum in our mind. It will create hunger in our mind. And when we open the book and see that point, then it will be, I can remember this now. And you will never forget that point again. Are you able to recall? Are you able to imagine what I'm trying to say? And you will not be feeling boring in the Lakshmikanth. And your time taken for completing the target will be very, very less. At least it will not be more than the passive study. It will never be more than the passive study. It will be either equal to or less than the passive study. How many of you agree with me? And it's not about agreeing. It's about trying this. Start doing this in all your preparation. I always recommend in all my batches, we have been doing this work in the mains marathon. And I'm recommending you to please do this work in the prelims marathon also. So how many of you actually can see that? Yes, it can really benefit, but there is a precondition. This can be beneficial only if you have already studied that chapter at least once. Okay. Now, so what you will be doing, you pick up the paper, you write down whatever comes to your mind. Now, next thing will be, you open the book. And I am assuming you have already gone through the book at least once prior to this exercise. Now, what you'll be doing, you will be opening the book and will just look into the point. And you will be, okay, I know this point. I don't know this point. Okay, I know. Now, those points which you are not able to recall, you will write those points in this sheet with a new pen, and that pen will be of a new font color. For example, if this pen is of red color, then the next pen will be of black color or blue color. So whatever information you don't know, you will be writing that information in the blue color or in the black color. Choose any one color. Now, what will be the benefit of writing in a different font color? The benefit is that when you revise on it the same topic next day or within a week, then you can revise only those things which are new or where you got confused or which you are not able to recall. Are you getting my point? What is the benefit of writing with a new font color? So in this manner, your time for revision also minimized. You will be just revising the relevant thing. And let me tell you, in the first attempt, I did not qualify. In the second attempt, I did this exercise and I qualified every time after the first attempt. And I was in a full-time job. I never took leave of more than 2 weeks before the prelims, but I was doing this exercise all the time. I will come from the office in the evening and will open the book and will just start thinking, will start writing what is coming to my mind. And then will start looking what I was not able to recall. And next day I will revise those things which I was not able to recall.